Connie, can you tell us how old you were when the war first started and what you were doing?
I was 9 years old. So, and I was with my big brother, see, my oldest brother, and he is already, Brick was about 18 by then. And, you know, I'm the only sister he got, so I can, you know, just do things I feel like saying and stuff. So we had a good time, but then pretty soon the priest looked at us and say, "The war started, so you all go home." Mm-hmm. And, well, to us, we don't exactly know what he was talking about. But we know it isn't anything good, because told us to go home, and we weren't naughty. We were pretty good. You know, we were behaving, and all of us kids. And so I look at my brother, and he says, "Hang on to me." So we, I got a hold of him, and then we just, you know, all, everybody just kind of ran home.
But how were your parents handling it?
Well, my dad was at home, but my mom, you know, was home. But we all, don't know what to do. We just all look at each other, and we're trying to think, are we seeing and thinking of what we should be thinking? Mm-hmm. And I don't know, I keep saying, "What's going on? What's going on?" And everybody is—they use the word "is what's going on." Mm-hmm. You know, what am I supposed to do? We just don't know what to do. Mm-hmm. So we all kind of get together, and our parents start putting food together so that in case we have done, we did have to go someplace. Mm-hmm. And you know, they took us to—I think it was at that time. I think it's to the school. You know, and they just put us in there, kind of keep us together because everybody's going all over. You know, because we don't know what's going on. Mm-hmm. And luckily that our parents, and we live right on this place down here, so it was easy for us to get to the school and back. But some of the kids, you know, had a lot more problem.
So where did you go after you went to the school?
We went to the school. We went home, and then we went to the school because that's where more or less everybody, you know, from the village get together. So we all kind of someplace back down this direction. But we all get together, and it was kind of nice because you know you're not alone to be scared or anything like that. Of course, we are kids. We don't know what's going on, and if you have a friend that you can play with. Mm-hmm. It's not really too much of a problem, but our parents, we can see that they're, you know, our father looks different and our mother don't know what whether to put them on their lap or, you know, whatever. Mm-hmm. But it was difficult, but we don't know why or anything. Yeah. And they're not telling us because they don't know it either. All they know is they exist. It's the war. And I don't know what war was at that time, you know, but it was... It was so difficult that it's kind of just, you got tight, all of us kind of just hanging on to each other. And, you know, and our parents keep saying, "Don't worry, we're okay." And with their arms around us, you know, it really helped us. But it was difficult.
Yeah. And you moved from your house to the school, and then you went to your family ranch?
Then we all went, you know, because we have a place back that direction. Mm-hmm. It's about, you know, half an hour walk to there. So that's where we went, and we kind of get together. So pretty soon, there's about five of us families, different families, kind of talk to each other because telephone is not, you know, available. So they are pack whatever you can get, mm-hmm. clothing and food or whatever. And we all just went to some place that was under a big breadfruit trees or either like that, but I forget, what's the other one that's not breadfruit? It's Duk Duk. So we kind of just all sit there as kids and the parents, you know, the one that really kind of doing everything. But all told, they didn't hurt us or anything, or just scared. Mm-hmm. But no shooting or anything on that order or beating us.
The Japanese.
Yeah. But then after that, they get us all kids together, and we, you know, they use us to pick things up or whatever they want us to do.
Was this at Thai?
Yeah. Actually, first we just work at the school here.
Oh, okay.
And then we all went to Thai, you know, because I think they're beginning to try to get everybody. So everybody is in Thai. Mm-hmm. What I mean, that place is full of people because everybody goes there because they said that if we don't go, they will shoot us, you know, because that means we're not, and you know, going according to their rules. And we don't know what's going on. We just, when they say go there, we just all kind of, and the family kind of all get together. But the thing I remember is the most beautiful thing is everybody is helping each other. When one kid's crying, the other one would help. And it's, to me, you know, because I was so young, but I was so engrossed in looking around to see what really is happening because our parents are all, you know, as they said, they're all shook up. We kids don't know what's going on. First, we got to Thai. And they kind of just put us all together, you know, in there. And it's a bunch of us, of course, you know, all of Sinahanya. And, but the people are tremendously good because we don't know what's happening. All we know is that we all have to be together. So we stayed there until, I think we stayed there for 2 days. And then they, you know, they come and they move us to wherever they are moving. And I can't remember right now just to where they took us, but they never heard us, in you know, because we follow the rules and regulations. You know, go and do your own thing.
So they didn't hurt you or do anything to you
at that time. There were two guys that they took in front of all of us. That's right, in front of us, and that they told us that they're gonna cut their head off, I mean neck off, to show us that that's what would happen to us if we do things that we are not supposed to, or not, you know, we're not supposed to do.
So you watched that?
So we have to watch it. That's all there's to that. There is no not watching. You better watch, because then, you know, they think you're against it or something. Mm-hmm. But we watched that two people being cut on the, you know, and we kids are there. And of course, we're all crying. I mean, nobody knows what they're doing. And our parents, of course, you know, they're not only that they're worried about everything, but their kids. And for us, it's not so bad because there's only three of us kids, but a lot of the Chamorros, you know, have a lot of kids. Mm-hmm. And my oldest brother was old enough to help. So my other brother and myself is the two that needed help. Mm-hmm. Because I don't know what was going on. I thought it was a lot of fun because, you know, the kids are running and all of that stuff. But it's scary because then when our parents sat us down and let us understand kind of what's going on, that you don't be running to places or go any place that you're not supposed to.
For the beheading, where you could look away, right?
Yes. You're not supposed to, and you're not supposed to cry either.
What would happen if you cried or looked away?
Well, they told us that we will be next.
You'd be next?
Mm-hmm.
Did that ever happen to
anybody? No, nobody. I'll tell you, we're all so good. No, well, how could you? You're so scared that you, but whatever they told me, I'll do it because, you know, it was difficult. You can't argue because they're already the big boss. But I don't know, the people are so good to each other. Is what I really remember, that we were scared and worried and all of that. Of course, I was, you know, much younger. And so as long as I have three kids playing with me, you know, that's a big deal. But what I remember, even on the adults, is that they all kind of get together, mm-hmm. and kind of share whatever feelings they have, or even whatever they got. And at that time, they too bitterness, you know, and they mm-hmm. share with each other their bitterness to kind of just get themselves together. Mm-hmm. But for me, it wasn't really too bad, because the only thing that we really cried so hard is because when we seen those two guys' head being cut off.
Those were Chamorros?
Uh-huh.
Did you join the march to Maningin?
Yes.
And did. You made it there?
You have to. Because okay. if you don't and they catch you any other place, they'll just, you know. And, but we never had problem because we follow as it. And what my parents did was, me, I carried the two blankets and two things, you know, to cover mm-hmm. ourselves. But our parents more or less carry. Remember them carrying one carries the water and the other mm-hmm. one what food we have.
So what was it like when you finally got to Maningin?
The thing that I remember is that there's not really, there is a lot of slapping. We can't figure out why they're slapping people. But we thought, well, you know, maybe they're not doing what they're supposed to do. You know, like we get spanking.
Mm-hmm.
Because when your parents say, you go and sit down there, you better sit down. Because I'll tell you, our parents, they don't touch you. They just look at you.
Mm-hmm.
And that's enough to kill you. Because they look at you and, oh my God, you know you're going to get, you know where there's going to be a pinch or you're going to get a best spanking.
Okay, well, thank you so much. I don't have any more questions for you. Your stories were wonderful.
No,
so
I
much information.
You,
thank
I
you.
I tell you everything that happened in our camp, you know, because see, it's different.
Thank you for joining us. Be sure to tune in again next week as we continue to bring to life some more stories of some of our island survivors.